scale of this award is of note. The top award is $100,000. There are 2 second prizes and 2 third prizes.
We had 120 applications from 30 states plus DC and 3 Canadian provinces. So for year one, we're looking really good.
UL thinks about environment in a very deep way, and in shaping this award, they are looking for us to think about how the whole planet is shaped by human action and what we can choose to make. So environment is the catalyst that every youth can see. It's the street in front of their house or the forest that they may go to. We see programs around the country experimenting in new ways with using environment as a path to STEM. What this award can do is draw attention to it nationally and help people replicate and find new ways to engage youth today in STEM learning and STEM careers.
Here we go.
There you are. Hi, guys. So nice to see you. So which one's Robin?
So I'm Robin.
Hi, Robin.
This is our director, Christine.
TRACS is a youth program based out of Trent University in Peterborough, Ontario, and our focus is on exploring environmental science from Western and Indigenous perspectives. In the teepee, we work with knowledge holders, elders, and the kids experience their own cultural knowledge as an equally valid way of doing science.
You're Greg and you're Dr. Carla.
I am.
At the University of Idaho McCall Outdoor Science School, or MOSS, we bring together graduate students who are getting their master's degrees in environmental education, fifth and sixth grade students, and their parents in an outdoor setting to work on the scientific identity of kids so that they can see themselves as scientists while they're practicing science.
Hi, Jacqueline, how are you? Oh, hello!
The Women in Natural Sciences program is a program to give girls from the school district of Philadelphia an opportunity to do science hands-on, specifically the natural sciences. We go and travel a lot of places in the city. What they get is a worldview of issues that are happening close to home that they wouldn't get otherwise.
Debbie, so nice to finally put a face to the name and all the communication.
Our project is Arts Plus Action Cafeteria Waste Reduction Program. And our goal is to achieve zero waste public school cafeterias.
Teachers, students, everybody is involved in the cafeteria. What we are really trying to achieve is to build a community of respect.
Respect for resources, for what you use every day and how you're going to dispose of it, reuse it, or recycle it.
Hi, Thea, how are you?
Future City is a competition program for middle school students. And they start with the question, what do I want the world to look like tomorrow? And from that, they develop a virtual city. They build a model using recycled materials. And then they present their city to professionals. Students are learning about environmental issues. They're learning why math and science is important to their future. And most importantly, they're learning about themselves.
We were really impressed with the number of high-quality applications we received. The top 11 were unbelievable, has made this a really challenging process. But not so challenging in the sense that we're actually really happy to tell you that you've been selected in the top tier 3 and will be awarded $25,000. And we are happy to announce that you are going to win $25,000 for your project for the UL Innovative Education Award. $50,000.
That's incredible! Oh, I don't want to cry.
You will be awarded $50,000 for the UL Innovative Education Award.
Great.
We are so happy to tell you that you and Future Cities have been selected as the grand prize winners.
Yay! Oh,
$100,000 obviously will be awarded to Future Cities.
Oh, I'm just so happy. This is such terrific news.
UL has, for over 120 years, been an organization that brings people together through collaboration, through inspiration, in order to truly live up to our mission, which is working for a safer world. UL's history was definitely in the electrical, mechanical, fire, and shock hazards. The whole consumer movement on household products that made our lives better, But in making them better, we also had to make sure that innovation and technology advance in a safe manner, and that was UL's history. Each year, 22 billion of those little ULs in a circle are applied to products. UL is now up to over 12,000 employees. We have 63 companies around the world. Never in 121 years did we feel we could do it alone, nor did we. And it is organizations and individuals like you that will make the world better than when we started at it.
And the winner goes to Future Cities.
The UL grant and award is like all UL. It's this amazing stamp of approval.
And a check for $100,000.
UL is such a respected science organization worldwide.
Moss.
For them to give us the nod and say this is a really good, important project for students to learn science is pretty fantastic.
And to be numbered as one of those organizations is a huge honor and gives us motivation to keep doing what we're doing and keep innovating.
For us, it really exemplifies the hard work that we've been doing over the past 33 years to get young women involved with STEM.
And now we know, it's confirmed that we're on the right track. We're doing something that's meaningful.
And when you have a chance, like today, to step back and not only think about your own work, but think about the work of others and how we're all part of an ecosystem, really, it's validating.
The possibility and potential for collaboration among the organizations is just so great. We're all in this together, and together we're making a difference.